Assalamualaikum, grade 6 science students. We are doing today recap of question number 1. Question number 1 is a microscope fitted with an 5 power eyepiece and 20 power objective lens. Which answer show how much the object will be magnified? Let me explain it by the help of microscope. Suppose you have put here a slide and you want to study an object. The eyepiece here is of the power 5 and the objective under which you are going to study the object is of the power of 20. So answer will be, total magnification will be both 5 multiplied by 20. So magnification, how much the object will be magnified? 20 multiplied by 5, answer will be 100. So that's why our correct answer was 100. Same is the case with question number 2. What is not a tissue? They have given us 5 options. Bone, B is nerve, C is blood, D is stomach, and E is epithelium. They are asking what is not a tissue. You know that what is tissue? A group of cells that are working together to do something special, some work. Bone is a connective tissue. Bone is a tissue. Nerve is also a tissue. Blood is also a tissue. Epithelium is also a tissue. You know that it is found in skin. So only stomach is there and it is an organ. That's why again our answer is D. So which is not a tissue? Stomach, D, because it is an organ. Welcome back again, grade 6 students. In science, we are studying cells, tissues and organs, unit number 1. And we are doing now today question number 3. Let me read the statement. Why do you usually need a thin piece of slice of a specimen to look at it under a microscope? See, this would be a specimen that we will be studying in a microscope. Suppose we have put anything to watch in microscope here. It should be very finely cut. What are we doing? Actually, this is light microscope. Light strikes here in the mirror and then it is reflected to the stage, passing through the hole, then entering into the objective lens, more magnified, and then entering into the eyepiece and then getting into our eyes. So the image is actually reflected from light rays coming here and going, reflecting from here to here. If the slice, the specimen, the object that we are going to study here will not be thin, will not be cut very light, very thin, then light will not travel through it and we will not be able to see. Got it? So whatever you are going to observe here, you should cut it very thinly, right? Now, question number 4 is, why are cells stained or dyed before being looked by microscope? The cells are stained or dyed. To dye means colored, to show up different parts, particularly the nucleus and the organelles. Let me show you some microscopic views. see. These are the microscopic views. If it would not have been dyed or stained, you couldn't see its nucleus. You couldn't see its cell wall. Same is the case if we say that we are observing animal cell. We would not be able to see animal cell nucleus and cell membrane if it would not have been dyed. That's why to see the different specimen parts, we have to dye it so that different parts give different colors. Now, our question number 5 is very easy. Question number 5 is, how many cells are there in a unicellular organism? Give two examples. You know that uni means one. Organism means living thing. Any living thing that has only one cell is unicellular organism. There are many examples like amoeba, chlorella. You can see from your book page number 5. The examples are also shown here. Single-celled animal. Okay? So they both are the unicellular organisms. That's it. Question number 3 till 5 are done now. Good morning, grade 6 students. How are you all? We are doing our chapter number 1, cells, tissues and organs. We have done question number 1 till 6. Now we will do question number 7. What is the statement? What is the function of the cell membrane? The cell membrane controls the movement of materials into and out of the cell. So the explanation should be done with the help of a cell. So I have taken an example of animal cell here. See, this is an animal cell. It has an outer black covering that is called cell membrane. It has a nucleus, it has a cytoplasm and vacuoles. All this cell material is covered by a boundary, the cell membrane. Now cell membrane is doing what here? Cell membrane is a gate with a guard. It is controlling and monitoring the entry of anything into the cell. One more thing it is doing. What it is doing? It is also helping in the excretion of waste material from the cell out of the body, out of the cell. So the answer is very clear. The cell membrane controls the movement of materials into and out of the cell. Now question number 8 is, what is the name of the green colored pigment inside the chloroplast? The green colored pigment inside the chloroplast is chlorophyll. I want to show it through the leaf structure. A leaf here has been magnified. See, its all cells are green colored due to chloroplast. Can you see? Chloroplast. Okay? See here? These green color chloroplast. These all green colored circles, chloroplasts have this green pigment called chlorophyll. This chemical, chlorophyll, is very important because it does photosynthesis. It helps the plant in making the food. That's it for question number 8. Thank you. Allah Hafiz. Assalamu alaikum, grade 6 students. In science, we are studying chapter number 1 and the unit name is cells, tissues and organs. And the question number is, name 3 different types of specialized cells. Which part of a cell determines how it will specialize? First of all, we will study the first part. Name 3 different types of specialized cells. The answer is, specialized cells perform a special job. For example, blood cells. Now, I want to show you that shape of any cell is just like to support its work. Look at here. at page number 4, red blood cells are shown here. You know that blood cells are white blood cells and red blood cells, but in your book at page number 4, red blood cells are shown. See, they are disc shaped and have red color. So their shape is specifically helping them to carry more oxygen around the body because they have biconcave disc-like structure. That's why they have more space to carry more oxygen. So this is telling you that why specialized cells have special function. Because their structure is specially helping them to do that specific task. Now, I have given here another example, nerve cells. Nerve cells are also found in animals. And it is actually found in our brain as well as in our spinal cord and in all our nerves. See, you can see here, the nerve cells have dendrites and their body is having many endings so that they can carry messages around the body. Their body is long and can send messages quickly due to their length. Okay? So it is second example is again telling you why the cells have a specific function. Specialized cells, how they are performing specialized functions. Now, I have given here three plant examples, plant cells examples. Root here are found at the tip of roots. Okay, all plants have root here. Root here cells have an extra protruding root which enters into the soil and absorbs water. Okay, see, if their root like structure would not be here, they would not be able to absorb water from the soil, right? Now, palisade cell, where are they found? Palisade cells are found in the leaf to do photosynthesis. So see, palisade cells have too many chloroplasts and can do easily their photosynthesis. So again telling you that their specific function of photosynthesis is due to their shape, is due to their chloroplasts. Now, I have given here another example, stomata. Stomata are shown in your book at page number 26. Not in this chapter, at page number 26. Stomata are found. See, these are the palisade cells and stomata are found at the lower one. See, stomata. Okay, these stomata, when magnified and seen under microscope, are like this. They have a pore. They have an opening that is closed or open for the entry of gases. Now, question number 6, second part is, which part of a cell determines how it will specialize? See, we were studying all type of cells. So, nucleus of the cell determines how it will specialize, how it will work. Thank you. Good morning, grade 6 students. How are you all? Hope you will be enjoying your lockdown studies. Okay, I know you are using first time journals. And today I am going to help you how you are going to write your all the question answers in your journals and how you are going to decorate it. And here I am going to give you a quick recap. Yes, we have done in the reading of page number 1, 2 and 3, what are living things made of and what is the name of our unit? Cells, tissues and organs. So we have studied that all living things are made of cells. So here I have given some points. Cells are building units of life. The two types of organisms are unicellular organisms and multicellular organism means the organism who have only one cell, they are called unicellular organism. For example, amoeba. I think question number 5 was also from this question. Okay. Multicellular organisms are those organisms who have many cells. Now, third point I have written, cells are so tiny that they can only be seen with the help of the microscope. So, we have studied microscope. It is on page number 10. See, you can see the microscope, it has eyepiece, it's a lens, and power magnification is written on the top of it with the sign cross, okay? There are two lenses that I use. One is eyepiece, this is eyepiece, and one, the other three are objective lenses, okay? They are also of different magnifications. Okay, this is the stage on which we put the slide with the specimen which we are going to study. So, the magnification of this microscope is actually the multiplication of eyepiece lens and objective lens. So, first question of our exercise was, what will be the magnification of eyepiece lens that was I think 20 and objective lens. And the answer was D, 100. Okay. We have also studied why we use stain. Why we use glass. We use glass to see clearly. And the light can pass through it. And there was another question which was asked that why we stain the things when we are studying under microscope. So we always stain the things so that we can understand which organelle is present, because you know that in cells the organelles, the parts of the cells are of different color and they stain differently, and that helps us whenever we are studying anything under microscope. So I'm coming back to the quick recap. Here I've made a quick thing for you. See, the green color cell is plant cell. Suppose I have seen this under microscope. The green color thing is plant cell and the pink color cell is animal cell. The common things which both cells have, I have written with blue pen. Cell membrane is outer covering, I have written with blue pen. Nucleus is the control master of the cells, blue pen. Vacuoles are many in animal cell and one in plant cell. Cytoplasm is the jelly-like liquid that is filling the cell. Okay. Now, two differences are there in plant cell. That is cell wall. It is the outer covering that is made of cellulose in most of the cells, in most of the plant cells. And the green-colored chloroplast. So, today we are going to study in question number 6 that name three different parts, different types of specialized cells, which part of a cell determine how it will specialize. Okay, girls and boys, you all have to use blue marker to give the topic heading chapter number 1, cells, tissues and organs. And you also have to use, see, I have used pointer, blue pointer and blue marker. Always put day and date. Okay, always draw margin lines properly. Okay, now I have written the question with blue pointer. See, there should be space so that you can easily write your answers in cursive writing pattern. I have written the answer. Name three different types of specialized cells. Why not I show you what are the examples of different types of cells. It is on page number 4. See, can you see palisade cells, root hair cells? These two above cells are present in plants. This red blood cell, these red blood cells, nerve cells and skin cells, they are present in animals. So their shape is actually according to their function. And how are they? The question is, why they are different according to their job and why, who is determining their specialization? So I've written the answer. Specialized cells perform a specific job. For example, blood cell carry the blood, oxygen and other things to whole body parts. So blood cells are, you have seen, nerve cells have have endings and they are long, so that they can carry the messages. Root hair, I have shown you that root hairs have small hair like structure so that water and mineral can enter from the soil into them. Okay, one more thing they are asking. They have shown what is the answer. Stomata. Stomata is not here, but here is palisade. I will show you in my other lectures stomata as well. So all the cells are specialized, are doing special job, but their specialization is controlled by which organelle, which cell part? It is the nucleus. Okay. Now question number 7, they are asking what is the function of the cell membrane. The cell membrane is the guard, is the outer covering and also the guard of the cell. So it is controlling the movement of materials that are getting into and out of the cell. Now question number 8 is, what is the name of the green colored pigment inside chloroplast? You know, I've shown here with a colored pen as well that chloroplast has green disc like structure and it has green pigment that is called chlorophyll. Okay, that's enough for today. Always write with blue pointer, blue ink pen and blue marker, and always write neatly. Do as much effort that satisfies you inner, and stay home, stay safe. Allah Hafiz. Assalamu alaikum grade 6 students. Today in science you're going to do question number 11, the end of your chapter, and it is, locate the sequence of page number 9 showing relationship between cells, tissues, organs and organism. See, we have all done this in level of organization in question number 10 as well. So using either label diagram, make up a similar sequence for a human being or some other animal. So I have taken the example of a human being. Why not we see first at our page number 9. Page number 9, they are giving example of of section of a leaf. See, all living organisms, whether they are plants or animals, are made of cells. So in the section of a leaf, they are showing you that leaf is made up of many cells. Okay, and the cells which are doing the same work, like photosynthesis is being done in palisade tissue. So this is tissue is shown here. So first of all, we will start from cells, then tissues. Okay, cells are here. Plant cells, they are working together in palisade tissue for photosynthesis. Then all palisade tissue are working in an organ. The organ of plant is leaf shown here, and then many organs are found in an organism. Here a plant is shown. So I am giving you the example of human beings here. See, organization of human body. If we start from red blood cells, these are the red blood, one red blood cell is shown here. So red blood cell, many blood cells work together as a connective tissue. Blood, you know that is a connective tissue. Then connective tissue and heart tissues are working together to form an organ. See, heart is shown here. Okay, then different organs are working together in circulatory system. This is an organ system. Okay, many organ system are making a human being, right? So It is your choice how you're going to write in your journal. You can write as a statement, as I have done with blue pen. I have written one example of the sequences: red blood cells, blood, a tissue, the heart, an organ, the blood or circulatory system, an organ system, and the human being, human body, organism. Or you can draw the diagram. Okay, you can, I have written here the sequence, but you can draw the diagram as well, as I have shown you. Okay, thanks a lot. Again, what is the sequence? Cells, tissue, organ, organ system, organism. That's all for this chapter. We have discussed many things about cells, tissues and organs. Stay safe, stay home. Allah Hafiz. Thanks for watching.